Welcome back. Traditional Chinese medicine is something that is by now very well known all over the world. But what about traditional Mongolian medicine? Mongolian doctors have a unique way of mending bones. In the past, the techniques were closely linked to their religious beliefs. The more modern practitioners have done away with much of the ritual that used to be associated with treatment, although to the outsider, there does appear to be an element of magic in what they do.
The Mongolians have been famous around the world for their strength and courage ever since their cavalry swept across vast areas of the Eurasian continent. It's said that along with their food and weapons, there was something else a Mongolian army never traveled without: their surgeons. With their traditional therapies, they were able to treat a wounded soldier quickly and effectively. Perhaps the most important of their remedies was the traditional Mongolian bone-setting therapy. There's at least one place where this traditional approach to medicine is kept alive. It's the city of Tongliao in Inner Mongolia Autonomous Region, where nearly half the population are ethnic Mongolian. In Tongliao, there is a clinic run by Bao Jinshan. Bao is a practitioner of the art of bone-setting therapy. The patient explains to Bao Jinshan that she has seen many physicians in the course of the past 9 months. Yet, there's been not the slightest improvement in her condition. When she was almost at the point of giving up, some friends recommended that she try traditional Mongolian bone-setting therapy. The clinic has two surgeons, father and son, who are the fourth and fifth generation of the Bao family Mongolian bone-setting therapists. Following a careful examination of the patient, they draw up a treatment plan. To the patient, having been confined to bed for 9 months, being cured within 35 days by massage sounds miraculous. The suggestion that she may after all recover is so unexpected that she can't hold back her tears. The Mongolian surgeons decide to remove the four long iron pins from the patient's leg immediately. Such is the patient's state of excitement that in the hope of calming her down, the surgeons ask her relatives to leave the treatment room. Unlike classical Western-style methods, Mongolian surgeons don't operate in treating bone injuries. They reconnect broken or cracked bones and replace them in their original positions solely by hand massage.
通过蒙医蒙药的治疗，这些病人接骨 比较理想，而且后遗症也比较少。
The patient's facial expression shows that the traditional bone setting therapy doesn't cause too much pain. The wonder is, though, how the therapist manages to apply his hand so precisely without seeing the injured bone with the aid of modern technology such as an X-ray.Having been massaged for a while, the patient can move her foot slightly.
术法服以后呢，骨头已经给对了，但是你不固定的话，它动弹以后又缩位了，不是吗？这小夹板呢，按照人体这个结构和那个弯度和这个直线。这个位置做成的一个呢小夹板，一般是柳木和这个松木，这些木头制成，它有个弹力，弹力。人的这个呢肢体的动静，它跟着这个呢，它就可以能活动了。
Throughout the massage treatment, one of the therapists keeps whistling sharply. He also sprays a liquid on the injured leg from time to time.The reason for this strange practice lies in the ancient origins of Mongolian bone-setting therapy. Traditional Mongolian medicine has its origins in the most ancient ethnic religions. The performance is a simulation of an ancient shamanistic sacrificial ritual. Shamanism used to be the dominant religion among China's northern ethnic groups. The master of a ceremony was called the Bo,and he acted as a spiritual medium between the gods and humans. He was believed to have the power to bring peace and fortune to his followers, and also to cure their illnesses. It was against this background that many traditional Mongolian medical therapies emerged, including bone setting.Bao Jinshan's great-grandmother, Narun Abai, founded a style of bone-setting therapy called the Bao School. Bao Jinshan shares his house with his son, Zhan Hong. In it, they keep some unique pieces of medical equipment used by the old women in bone-setting.
This is a stone bowl, right?哎呀，祖宗们用过的东西，我们应该是好好的尊重一下。
拿出来给我们看一下。
哎。这就是奢达化宝石，它本身是一个鱼白鱼，它用料呢已经200年的历史了用过。
As a child, Bao Jinshan was told the legend of the pair of jade stones. The story goes that one day, on her way to see a patient, Narun Abai came across a snake that had been severed in two. The kind-hearted doctor applied medicine to the snake's injuries and stitched up its broken body. After a while,The snake began to move. It then crawled into his cave twice, each time bringing out a jade ball, which it left in front of the therapist. From then on, Narun Abai used the two jade stones in all her treatment.
过去那个我们的那个祖先就用它，就是在那个外伤，比如是那个静脉断了哈，静脉断了以后，把它割到远端。完这个近端再给它压着，压迫止血，它有那种凉性，可以那个止血，再一个就是骨折端，它那个，就是软组织损伤特别厉害，肿胀的厉害，它搁那上边按摩，起到那个，促进活血化瘀的作用，
Since bone setting therapy, like many other traditional Mongolian therapies, was originally associated with shamanism, it's understandable that the Bao family are still keen to retell the myth of their family's medical traditions. Bao Jinshan says that in her day, his great-grandmother was identified with the Bo of shamanism. Bao Jinshan explains that although there was a time in the past when religion played a major role in bone-setting therapy, he and his son avoid any form of superstition in treating their patients. They don't think that as physicians, they possess any mysterious supernatural power. He explains, however, that some of the more proven traditional approaches are still used, such as the whistling and liquor spraying therapy. For several decades now, Bao Jinshan and his son have got up early each morning to perform their unique exercises. They believe they are essential for them to keep fit and maintain the strength they need to accomplish their strenuous job. The modern version of traditional Mongolian bone-setting therapy is different from both traditional Chinese medicine and modern Western practices. Yet there's no doubt that the introduction of modern technology is helping to revive the time-honored therapy. The efforts made by Mongolian therapists in Tongliao, such as Bao Jinshan and his son, in preserving and developing the ancient bone-setting therapy are being recognized by more and more people in medical circles, both at home and abroad.